Hi, welcome to my channel, Dragon in a Pot. Today we're going to be introducing a new video series, The Butcher, the Baker, the Candlestick Maker. RPG Forgotten Details. I hope this trailer gives information on what we want to cover with this video series, in adding just that little extra spice to your story that will give your players something to invest in. Three points that are oft forgotten that really do add that extra little bit of flair to your story are your merchants, giving them character, giving them a personality, and breaking them down into their smaller subsets so that your players aren't looking around the entire town for whatever it is they're looking for. Then you have your townsfolk. Who is populating your world? And what are their interests, goals, and how to make that simple but something that's there for your players to interact with. And of course, the setting flavor. What is your towns and cities smell, taste, look like? And how to improve these to give your players, again, that little something extra to bite onto and invest into that makes the world go from flat two-dimensional to three-dimensional just with those few extra words. First off, talking merchants, you have to have your butcher, baker, chandler that will provide them with their salted pork, their sausage for on the road. The baker providing breads and hardtack. The chandler providing them with candles, torches, and lamp oil. And then, of course, your blacksmith providing the maintenance on their swords and equipment. And, of course, then you have your bathhouses. Where do your players go to get clean? Your apothecary providing them with poisons, healing potions, and whatever else they may need to keep themselves hale and whole. And then, of course, your inn and tavern. Where do they go to relax and have dinner, and where do they sleep at night? And, of course, when talking townsfolk, you have to have the local soothsayer crying, "The end is nigh!" You have to have your drunk running in to and picking a fight with your barbarian. You have to have your town crier giving the local news from the Lord, whether that's taxes or the plague is upon us. You have to have your village idiot trying to sell dung to the players for their flowers that obviously are not present. You have your local lords giving commissions and bounties for the players to go after. You have your farmer who is desperately trying to grow their crops during this time of famine, that the players are trying to solve the problem of why is there famine when the river should be going through because the local mountain range is covered in ice and there should be plenty of runoff. These are just a few instances of who you can populate your villages and towns and cities with to give the players something to grab onto. And then, of course, you have your local flavor, whether that's talking smells, sounds, atmosphere, architecture. Do you need to create maps to give the players something to see and interact with? Or do you just need sketches that they can see of what first impressions do they get when walking through the front gates of the city? Or it may be as simple as just knowing these details yourself to describe to the players as they come across it. And of course, now that I've whet your appetite, I hope to see you soon in the next video of The Butcher, the Baker, the Candlestick Maker. This is Dragon in a Pot, signing off.